Hello, Healthy Hearts. Today we'll be talking all about omega-3 fatty acids. What are they? What are their health benefits? Their daily dose? How to increase your chances of getting more omega-3 from your diet? Omega-3 supplements? Who should be taking them? Who should not be taking them? And most importantly, are they really worth it or just a waste? So let's begin. What are omega-3 fatty acids? Omega-3 fatty acids are a type of buffer fat that are essential for our body because our body cannot make them. So we have to eat them in order to have them in our body. Now, why are they essential? Actually, there are two fatty acids that are essential. The ALA, which is from the omega-3 family, and the linoleic acid, which is from the omega-6 family. Although both are essential, but we are not concerned about the omega-6 part because that is already abundant in our diet. It is the omega-3 part which is decreasing and raising concerns for us. Now coming to the omega-3 family, there are actually three main important omega-3 fatty acids in this family: the ALA, EPA and DHA. ALA is the parent omega-3, which is the building block of EPA and DHA. EPA has an important role in decreasing cellular inflammation, and DHA has a vital role in formation and function of brain and retina, so memory and vision. Now, in a normal healthy person, 6 to 8% of ALA taken from food gets converted to EPA, and 0 to 4% of this EPA gets converted into DHA. Although the conversion is less, but this is what a healthy person on a healthy diet needs. But in case of pregnancy and lactation, when the need of growing brain and retina of the baby asks for more DHA, the mother's body converts more ALA into EPA, which is 21% now, and more EPA to DHA, which is 9% now, as compared to 0 to 4% the earlier. One more point worth noting is that the conversion of ALA to DHA is more in vegetarians as compared to non-vegetarians. So, is there a way that we can increase our chances of extracting more omega-3 from our diet? Yes, we should have a diet which is less in trans fat, less in omega-6 percentage, and we should not be taking junk food. If we do that, then more of the omega-3 gets extracted from our diet. Now, the benefits of omega-3 fatty acids. There are a lot of benefits. We'll name just a few, like it's helpful in keeping a healthy heart, formation and function of normal brain and retina, maintains healthy joints and bones, decreases osteoporosis, relieves menstrual pain, and keeps a healthy skin. But all these benefits come when you take omega-3 from foods. Daily dose of omega-3. Standard medical literatures have set recommended daily intakes for ALA only, because EPA and DHA can be taken care of if your ALA is in normal healthy range. It varies between 0.5 to 1.6 grams per day, depending upon the age, gender, and the physiological needs. Now, the omega-3 supplements. Before you start taking supplements, always remember two points. Number one, the health benefits of omega-3 supplements are not the same as that of omega-3 foods. They are a little bit disappointing. And second, there are always side effects associated with these supplements. Some are milder, some are severe. The milder ones, like fish aftertaste, bad breath, GI upset, can be taken care of by eating enteric coated tablets. But we are bothered about the severe side effects, which is association of omega-3 supplements with prostate cancer. Still, if you have to start supplement, kindly keep in mind the following point. Never start the supplement without being under doctor's supervision. Number two, if you are on blood thinners, diabetic, or have fish or seafood allergy, do not start fish oil supplements. My next two points come from the fact that fish oil capsules or supplements can have toxins in them. And what can you do so that you stay on the safer side? First is the methyl mercury. For that, you can go for molecularly distilled forms. The other one is PCB, the polychlorinated biphenyls. This is a chemical found in paints, plastic and rubber. This chemical is cancer causing. It's carcinogenic. Also, this chemical is lipophilic. That means it attaches itself to the lipid, that is the oil part. Now, what can we do to stay on the safer side? My advice to you is choose supplements that are made from fish that are short-lived, like sardines and anchovies, as compared to supplements that are made from long-lived fish like salmon, cod, tuna, because the longer the fish lives, the more toxin it accumulates into the body. And finally, always purchase a quality product. Look for certificate of analysis done by a third-party lab. So by keeping these points in mind, you should be a little bit on the safe side. Kindly let me know in the comments if anything else you would like to know about omega-3s, and do not forget to share the video with someone you think this video can be beneficial to. We'll meet in the next video on omega-3 foods. Until then, take care and bye-bye.